Hi. Today we are going to discuss about medical coding overview for beginners. Let's see. Once the patient had treated by the physician, the patient need to pay the bill. Usually the payment happen in two ways. One, the payment which is paid by hand, which is called as self-pay. The another way, the bill which is paid from the insurance. Here are some top US insurance name we are list out. For example, Aetna, Humana, Anthem, United Healthcare and Cigna. Let's see the overall insurance payment process, which is called revenue cycle management. First, the patient had treated by the physician, the patient need to pay the bill. What they will do, they submit their insurance form to hospital, where the hospital team, they will verify the insurance eligibility details, where the patient is eligible for complete payment or partial payment. If it is partial payment, they need to pay the bill by hand, the remaining payment by hand. Once the hospital team received the all details, they send the details to the data entry people, where the data entry people, what they will do, they will update the patient details to medical database. In that, what are the data they will update means, patient name, medical record number, date of service, and everything they will update in the insurance detail, everything they will update in that medical database. After that, they send to medical coder, medical coding team, where what the medical coder they will do means, they will review the face-to-face visit, that means a physician visit or anything. They will review the medical record. After that, they assign the unique code by using coding manuals, which is called CPT ICD HIPIX. We will see in detail in later videos. Once the coding process is done, they submit the claims to billing department, where the billing department, what they will do, they will assign the appropriate dollar value to the each procedure. Once the billing process is done, they send to the claims to payment posting, where the physician get the medical reimbursement from the insurance. If anything happen, anything mistake is happen, the claims it get denied. So the denied claim, which is processed by denial management people. Denial management people, first how they are resolving the claims means, they first will try to find out the where the problem is occurred. It may be a data entry part. For example, they may enter the insurance number, wrong insurance number, or maybe because of some keying error, maybe something happened. Or otherwise, it may be from a coding part. That procedure is not fulfilled for a medical necessity, maybe. If it is not fulfilled for medical necessity, they will clarify with the physician who is the responsible for the payment. They will clarify with the physician by AR follow-up. After that, they again submit the claims to payment posting. So once again submitted, the payment posting people, they will send the payment to physician. Once the physician got that amount from the insurance team, the patient will get a overall statement from the insurance team. Here, this is the overall view of revenue cycle management. Now we are going to discuss about the importance of medical coder. First, what the medical coder will do? Medical coder, they verify what type of work which is done. It may be a patient-physician evaluation note, or it may be a diagnostic procedure, or it may be a surgical procedure. They used to verify which work was done, and also they assign appropriate code by using CPT, ICD, HIPIX coding manuals for medical reimbursement. CPT, current procedural terminology. It may be a 5 character alphanumeric or maybe a numeric. which is maintained and regulated by AMA, which denotes for American Medical Association. This ICD manual is used to identify the service and procedure. For example, service and procedure means it may be a face-to-face encounter, or it may be some injection procedure. If a physician giving injection, for injection, physician will get the payment. Or it may be any surgical procedure. If they are clearing or any wound, or for that they will get. Or it may be any diagnostic procedure. It may be X-ray, CT, or anything. They will get. Here we list out some few example. 71010, which is denotes for chest X-ray. 93000, which denotes for 12-lead EKG. 44950, which denotes for appendectomy. 96372, which denotes for IM injection, intramuscular injection. And next coding manual. This is healthcare common procedure coding system. This also same 5 correct code, but this is only alphanumeric codes, which is maintained and regulated by CMS, which denotes for Center for Medicaid and Medicare Services. This book is used to identify the products and supplies and service not included in the CPT manual. For example, if here we list out some few example. For J3420, which denotes for vitamin B12 injection, and Q2039, it is for influenza vaccination. For example, if the physician giving the injection, for injection physician we need to quote code for injection from a CPT manual. For example, for IM injection 96372, for supplies, any type of medication, we need to quote from HIPICS manual. For example, if vitamin B12 means J3420, or it may be a testosterone injection, or it may be any other form. So for supplies purpose, we are using HIPICS manual. Let's see one more coding manual, which is called ICD-10-CM. Which denotes for International Classification of Disease, 10th Revision, Clinical Modification. CM denotes for Clinical Modification. These books contain 3 to 7 alphanumeric codes, which is maintained by WHO, which denotes for World Health Organization. This code book is used to identify for the diagnostics. It also used to avoid the fraud billing. Let's see the some example. Here we list out some example. R05, which denotes for cough, and R07.9, which is denotes for just fine, and J189, which denotes for pneumonia, and E119, which denotes for diabetes type 2. For example, how ICD manual helps to avoid fraud billing. If the patient came for the hand pain, if the physician taking chest X-ray, it's type of fraud billing. So it is unnecessary. If hand pain means, they need to try to rule out because what cause the patient experiencing the pain. They need to take some hand related X-ray or CT or MRI or something. Then only they can able to identify what is the problem. Instead of that, if you are taking different means, it's a type of broad billing. Let's see the good example. It's the same. If the patient came for the hand pain, if they are taking hand X-ray, they can able to rule out the cause of hand pain. This is the correct procedure for the hand. Let's see some few example for a better understanding. Scenario 1. Reason for encounter: patient has chest pain for past 2 weeks. Physician ordering the EKG. In that EKG final assessment, EKG was normal. That means result is normal. Let's see how to code this scenario. 93000 for EKG procedure. For a procedure, we are coding from CPT manual. Here there is no supply for EKG. There is no supply, so no need to code for HIPICS. And here for a chest pain, R079, which is the medical necessity for the appropriate procedure, EKG procedure. Let's see some one more example for better understanding. A reason for the encounter is same. The patient has chest pain for 2 weeks. The physician ordering the EKG. In that final assessment of EKG, which is proved as atrial fibrillation. This atrial fibrillation is the responsible cause for chest pain. So in this scenario, we need to quote that responsible condition. For example, 93000 for EKG, the procedure it's not changed. Supply, there is no supply. And for atrial fibrillation, I4891. So once the definitive diagnosis found by the procedure, we need to code the definitive DX. No need to code any symptom. And let's see one different example for a better understanding. For reason for encounter, the patient has vitamin B12 deficiency for 6 months. The physician ordering vitamin B12 injection via intramuscular. The patient tolerate the procedure well. Let's see how to code the scenario. Before coding, you try to code here what the procedure is done. Intramuscular injection. So intramuscular injection, we need to code from a CPT manual. And what they, one more, they giving supplies. That means vitamin B12 injection. We can code it from HIPICS manual. And for medical necessity, we can code a vitamin B12 deficiency for diagnosis. Let's see. 96372 for IM injection. J3420 for vitamin B12 supply. And E538 for vitamin B12 deficiency for diagnosis procedure. This is the overall process about how to code that medical record. The overall conclusion, today we discuss about the importance of medical coding. After that, the overall insurance process, which is called as revenue cycle management. After that, we discuss about medical coding, overall medical coding process. After that, we discussing about the coding manuals. And after that, we discussed about that some scenario, how to code that medical records. Thank you for watching our videos. If you like our videos, give the thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe our channel to get instant updates. And share our videos to your friend and colleague to crack the medical coding interviews. If you have any doubt or you want any more topic to cover, please give your comments below. We really very happy to help for you. Thank you.